Okay, in this video, I want to share with you my opinion, okay? My opinion about this Wuhan virus. Wuhan virus or this COVID-19 virus or whatever. Now, mind you, I'm just an ordinary human being. I'm not a scientist. I'm just a, school dropout, ordinary guy. But I'll give you, with simple logic, why I believe that this virus is man-made. Okay, now this is not a conspiracy theory, or I'm just giving you my opinion. Okay, so you can agree, disagree, whatever, and please don't take my word as gospel. Please refer links, take an educated do a little bit of research, and always trust where treatment is concerned. From vaccinations, don't do anything anky-panky. Okay, so I'm not giving you medical advice, I'm giving you an opinion. Okay, so having said that, now I'll tell you with logic why do I believe the Wuhan virus, or the virus, this COVID-19 is man-made. Now, if I tell you fever, everyone knows what fever is, everyone gets fever. Okay, if I tell you smallpox, everyone knows what is smallpox, we have vaccinations developed for it. Okay, if I tell you any disease, whether it's AIDS or whether it's leprosy, we all know about it because it has been there for some time. Now, when have we heard about a disease that has just stemmed up? Suddenly from somewhere, from some fucking unknown place, and caused a havoc. We have had these plagues, okay? We have had these plagues that have killed mankind, from bubonic plague to all these other plagues. You can check in British history. Or so all these plagues, all these epidemics or pandemics that have taken place at a tipping point, and they have wiped out the human race, or not the entire human race, a large part of it, until they found out the root cause and then the cure. Because even if you find the cure, but you don't eliminate the root cause, it will remain. Like, for example, you have a rotten teeth and your jaw is paining. So if you take painkillers or you take medicine to kill the pain, the rotting teeth is still there. So in order to sort it out, you have to pull out the rotting teeth, clean up that place, and then if you give antibiotics, then you're healed. Otherwise, you keep giving antibiotics or whatever, it will heal for some time, but then it will come back because the rotten tooth is inside. So same way, all these plagues, the black plague of death or the bubonic plague or whatever, is because of human activities, either waste, collection of waste, or they just dumped sewage and all that, or impure drinking water, human waste got into human drinking water, or rats were multiplying. And how did they multiply? Because food was being thrown in by human beings. So everything a human has done. Now, what happens with the Wuhan, or this COVID-19? Before you even get there, understand this much. And I'll tell you, my views were further strengthened by this book that I read. I'll put a screenshot of the book. I read the whole book. If you want a book review, let me know in the comment section. I'll give you a book review if you want. Now, this guy, this author, doctor, I can't get his name. Incredibly well-researched book. I loved reading the book. I read the whole book, line by line. Okay. He gives different plagues. How did they deal with it? But in that one sentence jumped out. I don't know which chapter it was, where he said that the governments, different governments of different countries, Russia, United States, all these countries, they research diseases, they research biological weapons, chemical weapons, they research, and it's done in top secret, okay? Now, the reason why the research is not just to use, but to develop and to find a cure for it, okay? Now, obviously, there are some countries that would use a nerve agent or something, but nobody will talk about it, so it's very hard to prove it. like that guy who's against the Russian government, he was poisoned by some man-made, you know, poison. Okay, so these are being developed by human beings. Now, among the various diseases and weapons that they have manufactured, like this anthrax powder, you remember there was this powder that was going on. You get an envelope, there is some dangerous powder and all. It was all developed by scientists. So now, what happens is somewhere down the line, you get these people who have this knowledge of creating these weapons, and either they can use it for bad or good. In almost all cases, they don't want to use it for evil purposes. It's not like what you see in Hollywood, use it to end the world. No, they'll use it only as and when required, with a very limited usage, so that there's no evidence. And even after they do it, they'll make sure they wipe out the evidence. Otherwise, you'll have a massive political and global scandal. Okay. So now what happens is, when you have these countries developing these weapons, like they said, you know, when World War was fought, it was fought with tanks and guns and bullets. Then the second warfare was fought with, you know, like these weapons, like, you know, nuclear bombs and all that. The third was this chemical and biological warfare. Okay. Now the next one is information, IT. Okay. Knowledge from networks. Now from there, it is going into artificial intelligence. That is why they are hacking into systems and they are harvesting data. So it's moving into more advanced forms. So this diseases, even though people thought it was primitive, if you see Bill Gates' TED talk, he said the next pandemic is going to be that of a disease, respiratory, heart related. And it's true, because today, if you actually look at it, look at mankind, look at the people in the Western countries. They're eating themselves to death. They're obese. They have blood pressure, they have sugar, they have diabetes, they have heart-related issues. They are so fat and so unhealthy. If you see so many men and women, I mean, they're fucking, the female's tits are from here to the knee. The guy's stomach is so big, it comes till his kneecaps, man. And some of them are actually sitting on these, I don't know, this three-wheeler, small little, I don't know, scooter or something. And with that, they are driving to McDonald's to order a burger. These foods have very low nutritional value, but very high caloric value. Very, very high. So, and they have designed this food in such a way that you cannot eat just one. You want to eat two, three, four. And because it is very soft, easily digestible, if you eat one, you automatically want to eat more. And that is why they give you French fries, why they give you burger with French fries, which is salty, with a cold drink that is cool with sugar, with the, let's say, a hot snack that is sugary or crispy with salty. So all the areas of your tongue, whether it's salt, whether it's sugar, even umami, you know, that softness, the texture, they make sure that all these areas are ticked. And these burgers, pizzas, hot dogs, artificially created foods are made by scientists. You know, do you know that a burger, even the smell is engineered in a laboratory? Even the taste, when you're buying a barbecue burger, or when you're buying a Texas burger, or when you're buying a chicken or fish, the taste of that chicken or fish, the appearance of chicken or fish, the smell, everything is chemicals. And they manufacture this in labs. It's so shocking, I'll tell you. You know, if you actually see the beef patty, it has no taste. Just do your research. A beef patty has absolutely, which they serve in McDonald's, Burger King, has no taste. It's when you put these drops of chemicals or whatever to this beef, then it gives out the taste. Then it gives out that smell. There are different, like there are 50 to 100. I spoke to one food scientist who was my client. He said, Lloyd, there are 1,000 plus smells, 1,000 plus tastes, like burger, for example, charcoal burger, semi-charcoal burger, honeycomb burger, what is that, Texas Roadhouse burger. All these chemicals, they're just like they look like water, but when you put the drop, it gives that flavor or that smell. So all this is manufactured in labs. Now, after you create all this artificial, like watermelon, Today, the watermelon, the apples look redder, the oranges look bigger. The, like, how are you mass producing eggs, chicken, beef? All these are chemicals. In fact, today, you know, the animal industry itself is, like, look at the chickens, they are plump. They're so fucking plump. Look at a normal chicken from the village, it's so skinny. How are these chickens so plump? How are they so juicy? It's all chemicals. So now, when you have such a world that is created with chemicals and scientists and human knowledge so advanced, you think they can't create these diseases? Now, I'm not saying that they create these diseases to kill people. They create these diseases to study them and to study the impact. Like even Elon Musk is developing a neural transmitter fitter that will control, you know, the mind. See, even though US is saying cloning is not allowed, you think secretly they're not doing it somewhere? You think Russia, Iran, European countries are not secretly doing it? See, check during the World War. Russia, even US was doing secret testing. Okay, they were testing on nerve agents, they were testing with human beings, they were testing with all illegal tests. And these are historical facts, you just have to research. They experimented with chemicals, like giving them a serum which will make them tell the truth, then experimenting, giving them like electric shocks to see how they react. They've tried all these crazy stuff. That is from where you think the science fiction movies of zombies, they put different parts on their body to see, can they build a Frankenstein? So yes, some of them are urban legends, some of them exaggerate, but these are things that have happened with mankind. So same thing with this Wuhan kind of virus or whatever. They say it originated from a laboratory, okay? Now, how did it get out? Did they, you know, drop a test tube and it leaked? Or did it escape from a small crack in the test tube or something? Or did they purposely try it in a small area to see how would people react? And if they give them the vaccine, would they be okay? That is a big question that nobody can answer. That we can only speculate, okay? But the way, if you see, the way China has handled it, their response was fast. They eradicated it so quickly. And now China is normal. Now, the funny thing is China is normal, but every other country in the world is abnormal. Have you noticed? China is normal. Everything is going fine with China. But everywhere else, everyone else is abnormal. So if I were a conspiracy theorist, I'll be like, fuck, this was a good game plan China pulled. But then again, if I was an advanced level conspiracy theorist, I would say that US and China, you know, secretly have, okay, you do this so that we can achieve this agenda or whatever. But then again, maybe, you never know, maybe Russia and China agreed, or maybe China did it by themselves. You know, there are never-ending conspiracy theories, which I don't want you to believe anyone. All I'm telling you is, through this video, I personally believe this virus couldn't have just come out from nowhere. This bullshit that they're giving, it came from bats. Why? There were no bats until now. No human being interacted with bats. You know, if you read this book, which I told you, no? I don't know, Dangerous something, I can't get the name, it's a yellow book. You know, for a disease to jump from animals to human beings, it takes thousands of billions of years of evolutionary development. It can't just from one species jump to another just suddenly. It takes years and years. And if it has happened so suddenly, just think. Before 2020, how was your life? December, before the virus spread in China, how was your life? All of a sudden, what the fuck happened, man? What, you expect me that one incident from one person spread to the whole world? What the fuck are you talking here? So for me personally, I'm of the opinion this originated in a lab. It was originated in a lab. Okay. And China knows the cure for it, or knows how to control it, or whatever. That is why China has controlled it. Everyone's okay. Now the question is, do you need a vaccine? Yes, of course, if there's a disease, you have to take a vaccine. Should you take a vaccine? My opinion, yes, you must. Do I think that this virus is going to control the world? It's used by the New World Order? No, I don't think so. That's a little too far-fetched. too much of science fiction there. But I'll limit my opinion to the fact that it is a man-made, it's certainly a man-made disease, just as you have all these plagues. Man is, you know, when you look at nature and everything normal, there's no problems. Everything from diabetes, blood pressure, joint pain, steroids, processed foods, all these are created by man. Why do you think people are so fat and overweight and hogging food? And because food is engineered to be made delicious and don't eat just one. If McDonald's and Burger King and everyone ate only one or small meals, they would go in a loss. They need you to eat more. The more you eat, the more they make money. How do you think hospitals and the medical industry makes money? If you're not sick, how will a hospital survive? So many hospitals, why do you think they charge so much money? Why do you think insurance companies charge so much of interest for insurance? Because if you don't get sick, nobody will take the insurance. So it's a man-made system that is designed for a certain agenda. So in my personal opinion, I feel this virus was made in a lab for a particular purpose. How did it get out or why did they allow it just to grow? That is anyone's guess. But I can assure you, this didn't just jump from bats and suddenly one person got infected in the whole world. I mean, come on. You need common sense to know that is bullshit, man. Anyway, this is just my opinion. Who the fuck cares anyway? I'm just a ordinary, small, piddly guy with 40,000 subscribers, hardly 200 views, half naked in a forest, school dropout. Who the fuck cares? Anyway, let me know your thoughts, okay? I'd be very interested to know what you think. You guys take care.